People, this is Kiran Naik from iTech Hope. In this video, we are going to present you with a tutorial of how to make a ball bounce in Java. So let's first see the logic so you can implement it in any of the other languages. So as you can see, a ball is bouncing to and fro in this particular frame. So as you know, in computer or you can say in Java or anything, so here it is, this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. And this point, 0, the origin. So let's first see the logic or what happens when a ball moves and what happens when it collides with the wall. So yeah, here you can see the ball is bouncing to and fro, that is left and right. So the x value is constantly incrementing and decrementing. So as the x reaches 0, it bounces back to the right, and when the x reaches its maximum width, it bounces to the left. So if we take an element, so if the ball is placed at x, you can say that if the ball is placed at 200, so when it's going back, it is constantly decrementing, and as soon as it reaches the minimum point, it will constantly go on incrementing. So it is, you can say 200, 199, then 0. And then from 0, it's going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, for y, you can say, yeah, it is going constantly up and down. So here it is the y, 0, that is the minimum point, and it is the maximum point, that is the height of the frame. So as you can see, the value of y is constantly incrementing and decrementing, similar to that of x. So when the y reaches 0, it gets collide with the frame and it bounces down, and when y reaches its maximum height, it collides with the bottom wall of the frame and it bounces up. So what actually happens now, let's have a peek. So here is our code. These are packages that are need to be implemented. I have taken I've imported the util package, I imported the AWT package and the swing. So now let's see. I've taken a class called as ball, and I've extended a JPanel class. So why I've extended that class is, I will tell you later on. So here are the x and y coordinates of my ball, the width and height, and the decremented value. Okay, now let's go to the paint class. So this is, I am painting the panel since I have extended it. Now let's just ignore these two lines for a particular time. Now I have used a graphics object, and I have made an oval placed at x and y with the given width and height. See, I have taken these variables here. X, y, x is 200, y is 250, width 50, and height also 50. So when I have placed it at a particular point, and then I have made a frame object. So I have to show a frame. If I have to display something, I have to include it in a frame. So I have given you a frame, the properties of frame, set the foreground of the panel. Foreground of the panel, since you are adding the panel to the frame. As you can see, I have added the panel, that is the our class object, to the frame, and made the foreground of the panel as red. I have used the timer class from the util package. You can also use the timer class from the swing package, but you have to implement the action listener and the method action perform. So as we need to know the logic, so as the ball moves left, its x value is decremented, and as the ball moves right, its x value is incremented. As the ball moves up, the y value is decremented. As the ball moves down, the y value is incremented. So what happens is, I have used a method of the timer class as schedule fixed rate, which needs the parameter of new timer task, an object of new timer, the initial start and the given delay of how after how much time the event should occur. If I give here 20, see what happens. Yeah, the time is in milliseconds, you have to remember that. You have to give the time in milliseconds. If you are writing, if you have to perform a particular task in 2 seconds, then you will have to give 2000 there. See, the ball is moving. But it is not as it was previous. So it is moving with a specific delay. Yeah. The Y value is constantly decrementing as well as the X value. And as soon as it collides with the frame, it bounces back. So here is the logic. I have used dx as the parameter, dx and dy as the parameter to move the ball. Okay. Dx and dy as the parameter, which will constantly move the ball in the specific directions. So if you can see that the ball is moving left to right, that is the x value is constantly changing. Now why this is happening? See, dx is, the value of dx is 1, okay. Now the x value is constantly incrementing and decrementing by 1. So this is being placed at 200. The x is, you can see here, the x is incrementing first. So when it increments, it goes to the right, and as soon as it collides, that it reaches its maximum width, it bounces back, it goes to the right. So you can see that I have written a code here which says, as soon as the value of x gets greater than the width minus 45, this is the value which gets covered for the boundary here. The boundary takes the value 45. So as you can see that as soon as the value of x becomes greater than the width, specified width, the dx becomes minus 1, so it goes back to the left. And as soon as the value of x becomes less than 0, it bounces back to right, that is dx becomes 1. So x is constantly increasing as soon as the value of x reaches less than 0, and it's constantly decrementing as soon as the value of x becomes greater than the specified width. Similarly, for y, if I have to show what happens with y, then you can see that, the value of y is now decrementing. Okay, so as soon as it reaches its minimum value, it bounces down. So dy becomes plus, dy equals becomes 1, and as soon as the value of y, I'm seeing that the value of y is constantly increasing, and as soon as it reaches a specified height, the value of y keeps on decrementing. You can see that I have given here dy is equal to minus 1 when the value of y exceeds the specified height, and the dy is equal to 1 when the value reaches its minimum limit. So this is the logic to make a ball move as well as make the ball act according to the collision. So as you know, if you do not want to take the timer class, you can also take the thread class, thread.sleep, and give the specified time at how much amount do you want to sleep. But then you will have to make this method run an infinite amount of times. So I have just used a very efficient method here. So yeah, now coming to why I have extended the jPanel class and why these two lines are included. So the basic reason why I have extended the jPanel class is to avoid it from flickering. So what basic flickering is and what thing we have to do to avoid it is presented in the video, or you can see in next videos. You have to just know now, for now you can have the knowledge that jPanel has the double buffering by default, so it helps to avoid flickering. And for now, what this line does, you can note that it just improves the quality, that is, improves the rendering. So here it is. Here I have shown you exactly how the ball bounces and what basic logic is used. So here it is. The ball is bouncing to and fro, up and down, according to the coordinates, incrementing and decrementing its x and y. So if you like this video, do subscribe us. There are many more videos coming. And if you have any doubts and if you want some other videos, some other tutorials, just make your point noted in the comment section. Thank you.